Hi everybody, we are discussing about alcohols. Today we will discuss the physical properties of alcohol. So physical properties. In case of alcohols of lower members like methanol, ethanol, they are colorless volatile liquid and they have a alcoholic odor. Higher members, if we increase the chain length of alkyl part up to 13, 14, 16, they are waxy solids. Alcohols consist of two parts. One is called alkyl part and other is the hydroxyl part. And the properties mainly depend on the hydroxyl part. Next, we'll discuss the boiling points. Now, we'll discuss the boiling point of alcohol. The boiling point of alcohols are much higher than those of the alkanes, and this is because of the polar nature of the alcohol molecule as well as the presence of intermolecular hydrogen bonding. If we write the boiling point of alcohol, then you can easily understand. If we think about the propane, its molecular mass is 44. That is molecular mass. And its boiling point is 231 Kelvin. Boiling point. Now, if you think about the ethyl alcohol or ethanol, in this case, its molecular mass almost same 46, but its boiling point is 351. If we think about dimethyl ether, its molecular mass is also 46, but its boiling point is around 309 Kelvin. So, from here, you can easily understand that alkane and alcohol has much higher boiling point compared to the alkane, and ether boiling point is less than alcohol. This is because of the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. If we write the structure, then you can easily understand. Suppose this is alcohol, another alcohol. So here this hydrogen attached with oxygen will form intermolecular hydrogen bonding with the another oxygen atom of alcohol molecule. So this is intermolecular hydrogen bonding, and there will be long association of this molecule through intermolecular hydrogen bond. That is why their boiling point is so higher. Now, if you think about the boiling point of alcohols for higher molecular, like methyl alcohol, then ethyl alcohol, then propyl alcohol, butyl alcohol. So here we are increasing the molecular weight. Definitely the boiling point will also increase. Next, we'll discuss the boiling point of alcohols if we increase the branch of the alkyl. That means branch chain isomers of the alcohols. Generally, in case of branch chain, the alkyl part, surface area of the alkyl part is decreasing. So, definitely the boiling point will decrease. If we think about butyl alcohol, this is butyl alcohol, its boiling point will be around 391 Kelvin. Next, if we increase or make branch, this is isobutyl alcohol. In this isobutyl alcohol, the boiling point will be around 370 and Kelvin. And if we think about tertiary butyl alcohol, so here we also increase the branching, they are around 353 Kelvin. So branch chain isomers have lower boiling points than straight chain isomers because here van der Waals attractive force is more, okay, as well as here the alkyl part is the less, so surface area is less, so boiling point will decrease. Next we will discuss the solubility. We know that alcohols are highly soluble in water. Solubility. This is because of hydrogen bonding. Lower alcohols are generally soluble in water because of intermolecular hydrogen bonding. But we increase the alkyl chain length, if we increase the nonpolar part, then the boiling solubility of the alcohol will decrease. And if we increase the branching, then also the solubility of the alcohol will increase. Next, we'll discuss the density. All liquid alcohols are generally less denser than water. And next point is intoxication nature. Ethyl alcohol or ethanol has been the most used alcohol for drinking purpose in cold countries. Methanol is poisonous because it is not suitable for drinking. It may cause blindness as well as death also. If we take a greater quantity of methanol, it can cause death also. Now, alcohols cannot be dried over anhydrous calcium chloride and magnesium chloride as they form addition compound with their salts. With these salts, that means calcium chloride and magnesium chloride, they will form salts. Next, we will discuss the chemical properties of alcohol. Alcohols that have the ROH bond in presence of active metal, these OH bond will break. If we take the ethanol, and in presence of sodium, it will form sodium ethoxide, C2H5O minus Na plus, plus there will be formation of hydrogen. We can think about aluminium, we can think about magnesium or potassium, they will give the same type of reaction. Okay, so the highly active metals will react with alcohol and forming corresponding alkoxide as well as hydrogen gas. Alcohols are weaker acid than water, and acidity of order of alcohol is primary, then secondary, then tertiary. Acidity order. Primary alcohol, then secondary alcohol, then tertiary alcohol. Why? Because if we write their alkoxide, this alkoxide is more stable than this alkoxide or this alkoxide. Tertiary butyl alkoxide. Because here 3 methyl group is there. Because of the 3 plus I effect, this is not stable. But here only 1 plus I effect, here 2 plus I effect is there. That is why this primary alcohol, that conjugate base is very much stable compared to the other secondary and tertiary alcohol, and so this is the acidity order. Now if we discuss the basicity order of the alkoxide, this is just the reverse. Basicity order of alkoxides. So that is just the reverse. So this one is the highest basic, then this one, then this one. Next we will discuss that alcohols can act as a Bronsted base. In presence of sulfuric acid, this alcohol oxygen will take the proton and it will form OH2+. So here alcohol is acting as a base, that is why it is called Bronsted base. Next we will show another reaction, that alcohol, if we react with sodium hydride, that will react with alcohol forming the corresponding sodium alkoxide, sodium ethoxide plus formation of hydrogen gas. Next we will discuss the esterification reaction. Esterification reaction also will break the OH bond. That esterification reaction will break the C-OH bond. CH3, C double bond O, OH. And here we are using that alcohol plus C2H5OH, and we are adding concentrated sulfuric acid. This is acting as a catalyst. From here we will get the ester plus H2, and this reaction is very popular and this is called esterification reaction. And by this reaction we can identify the acid, because esters have a pleasant fruity smell, as well as we can identify also alcohol. Now these esterification rates, if we increase the alkyl group, that means if we go from primary to secondary to tertiary, from primary the esterification, for primary alcohol the esterification reaction will be higher compared to the secondary alcohol, then tertiary alcohol. And if we increase the alkyl branching or branching in the alkyl group of the acid, then the esterification rate will decrease. That means formic acid esterification rate will be higher than acetic acid, then this acid, and the rate will be slowest in case of trimethyl acetic acid. The esterification rate decreases as we increase the branching, and that will cause most probably the steric hindrance. Next, we will show the mechanism of esterification reaction. And this mechanism is in your syllabus, so you have to understand this mechanism. First step is the protonation of the acid. So we are taking that acetic acid and sulfuric acid will give this proton, is coming from H2SO4, and this lone pair will accept the proton, and this is the first step, that is called protonation of the acid. In next step, what will happen? There will be formation of positive charge on carbon atom. Okay. And this one is also resonance stabilized. So this is very much stable. Now this alcohol will attack here. C2H5OH. CH3C, OH, OH, plus C2H5. In next step, there will be deprotonation, or to release the H+, forming CH3C, OH, OH2 plus, all states are reversible, okay? And OC2H5. Then there will be elimination of water molecule. Last charge, elimination of water molecule. So we are getting CH3C, OH plus, OC2H5. In next step, it will stabilize by resonance. And in final step, there will be deprotonation. It will liberate one proton, you have H plus, and finally we will get the ester. So this is the esterification process. So in the first step, there is protonation of carboxylic acid. In the next step, neutrophilic attack of alcohol. In the third step, deprotonation, and then protonation. Finally, the elimination of water molecule, and at the last step, there will be deprotonation to get the corresponding ester. Now, we can prepare ester also from alcohol, from acid chloride. That is another reaction. If we take CH3COCl, that is acetyl chloride. Here, if we give any alcohol, C2H5OH, this OH also will attack here, and finally there will be release of Cl minus, and we will get CH3CO, O, C2H5 plus, and by deprotonation we will get ester. So, by using alcohol in presence of acetyl chloride, and here we have to use one reagent or one base, that is pyridine. So in this way also we can prepare ester. Next, we'll discuss the reaction involving the cleavage of COH bond. We have already discussed in case of formation of alkyl halide. If we take alcohol, if we give anhydrous zinc chloride and HCl, that will produce the corresponding alkyl halide or C2H5OH. This is ethyl alcohol. Here we are adding HCl and anhydrous zinc chloride, that will produce ethyl chloride, plus there will be formation of water. Now this is one SN2 type of reaction. Actually here we have already discussed that CH3CH2OH, in presence of acid it will become CH3CH2OH2 plus, and from the backside that Cl minus will attack, and finally we will get the corresponding halide or ethyl chloride. Now if we want to insert Br here, we have to use concentrated sulfuric acid and HBr. If we want to add in here, then we have to use HI and apply heat. But if we use red phosphorus and hydroiodic acid at the temperature 420 Kelvin, then we will get the methane, water and iodine. So these are one kind of reaction. And another method we have already discussed in alkylite, that if we add reagent like PCl3, TCl5, then alcohol will react with it, and this reagent with this reagent, and that will form the corresponding alkyl chloride. But if we want to prepare alkyl bromide, we have to use PBr3. Or if we want to prepare the corresponding iodide, then we have to use Pi3, okay, and red phosphorus and iodine. And one very important reaction that I have also discussed in alkyl halide, the Dargen reaction. Here, the best method is the if we add alcohol thionyl chloride SOCl2 in presence of pyridine, that will form C2H5Cl plus sulfur dioxide plus water. So sulfur dioxide plus HCl. So these are gases. So here purification process is not required, and we will get the best method. Next we will discuss that the acidic dehydration of alcohol. If we take any alcohol, suppose we are taking ethyl alcohol C2H5OH, and we are adding concentrated sulfuric acid here, and here we have to use the temperature 453 Kelvin, that will produce ethylene plus water. Now this is called acidic dehydration of alcohol. Now if we take one secondary alcohol, the reaction will be easier. We have to take only phosphoric acid H3PO4, and around 453 Kelvin it will form the corresponding alkene plus H2. Now if we take the tertiary alcohol, then the reaction conditions becomes more milder, too milder. So here only 20% phosphoric acid H3PO4 is required, and temperature is also less, around 350 Kelvin. That will produce the corresponding alkyl and water. Now, what is the mechanism of this type of reaction, or dehydration, acidic dehydration of alcohols? That is in your syllabus and you have to understand. So here, in the first step, in presence of sulfuric acid, this oxygen will be protonated and it will form OH2 plus. And in the second step, plus HSO4 minus. And in the second step, there will be elimination of water molecule, and there will be formation of carbocation. And in the third step, there will be formation of alkene, that HSO4 minus will abstract this proton, and there will be formation of CH2 double bond CH2 plus H2. So in this way, we can prepare alkene by dehydration method of alcohol, acetylized dehydration method. But if we think about the tertiary or secondary alcohol, the rate will be higher. In case of tertiary alcohol, the rate is faster compared to the secondary alcohol, and the rate will be slower in case of primary alcohol. Next we will discuss the formation of some rearranged product. So if I take this alcohol, this is butanol, and if we add concentrated sulfuric acid and apply heat, then there will be formation of alkene. This alkene is expected, but that is minor alkene, and it is only 20%. Then what will be the major alkene? Major alkene will be this one. This one is 80% major. So what is happening here? So we know that first there will be protonation, and there will be formation of this type of carbocation. Now this carbocation is not stable. So here shifting will be the hydrogen, and this is called rearrangement step, and here these carbocation will rearrange to more stable 2 degree carbocation, and in the next step there will be elimination of this hydrogen and we will get the more substituted alkene. And if we think about this type of alcohol, here also if we give concentrated sulfuric acid and apply it, then we get the rearranged alkene. That will be the major product. So we can understand the dehydration of alkene, that is by acid catalyzation. So today up to this, and next day we'll discuss more about the chemical properties of alcohol. Thank you. Stay at home, stay safe.